27, Paxton Malone. At 4, number 39, Bryce Woodward. And in goal, number 27, Eric Peterson. Now, presenting your CSU Rams starting lineup, please welcome back number 49, Austin Anstead.
Here we go, boys. All right. Starting for your Colorado State Rams, we have Grayson North from San Jose, California. Starting at the number 20, Yuval Mokendahl. Start forward, starting 27, Max Legere. Number 28, Kyle Riley Parker. Oh, it started at left defense. We got Noah Burger.
And this morning, ladies and gentlemen. And starting with goal, we got Joe Morgan. Now please welcome Glenn, the senior of the year and alum who graduated in 1987 from CSU, who will be playing our national anthem. So please rise and remove your caps as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Castro here with Tristan Anderson. You're watching ColoradoSports.tv. We've got all the action covered for you tonight. This is Colorado State University's last game of the season, and they are taking on the University of Nevada, Las Vegas, UNLV. Tristan, it's the last game of the season. How are you feeling right now?
You really caught me off guard. Yeah, well, I was not ready to talk yet. Do they actually have more? I think they might have more. I think this is the last home game.
I'm pretty sure this is the last game. If you take a look at their stat sheet, doesn't have a next game listed there. So I believe, unless they've changed up the schedule since I last looked at it, this is supposed to be their last game of the season. But the puck has been dropped and we have begun. Last time we were here was last weekend when Colorado State took on the CU Buffaloes. And they came away with an overtime victory win with 5.8 seconds left to go in that overtime match. And right now the puck is on the Colorado State defensive end. Rams trying to get it out, and they do. It's come out to center ice, taking it down the middle here is Max Legere for the Rams. Puck comes in deep, Riley with a hit along the board. Puck comes out of the zone, Corey Taylor is gonna hand it off. Puck gets knocked back into the UNLV zone. Big players for this UNLV side. They've got lots of point scorers. Four players actually with over 20 points to their name. So they got a lot of big playmakers on that side, and the Rams are gonna have to have some good defense. in today's set of action. And puck is knocked out of play as UNLV was trying to get into the zone.
I was watching this team warm up as we were waiting for our broadcast to start, and I could say that this UNLV team definitely has some nice shooters. I was watching them hit the crossbar, bar down every time. Everyone making it, just sniping those corners. And that'll probably show in today's game with the way they have been playing.
Maybe that's something Morgan will have to watch out for, but right now the attack is going on the other side. Rams trying to get something going. But the Rebels are not going to make it easy for it. Puck gets tangled up along the boards. Players battling to break it free. And it comes loose. Coming out near the center. This might be a shot here. Nelson tries to pass it in deep, but it gets blocked on the way there. Puck still in the zone. Rebels just trying to get it out. Get on the stick with that one. That's a stick going flying. That was Millar who lost his stick on that play. Right now it's coming back in. Cote tried to carry it in. Joseph able to get on his stick. He takes a shot, and that's a save.
A great shot and even better save from the UNLV goalie, who is all the way from Sweden, at least what we have here. Hopefully this is right. Erik Edenson.
Erik Edenson in goal for the Rebels tonight. He's got a record of 3-2. On the other side, you have Joe Morgan, his record being 9-10. So both goaltenders obviously looking to come away with wins tonight. Big hit along the boards as the Rebels are trying to get the attack going on this Rams side. A little back and forth in the corner. A little bit of pushing and shoving as the puck is caught in between the skates of a few players. Coming around Morgan's net, trying to send it around to Gillis. Comes along the boards again. Moreno giving a hit of his own. Puck sent around again. Harrison going to carry it on his stick for the Rebels. He's going to leave it for his man as the Rams are applying a lot of heavy pressure right now on both sides of the ice, and we're seeing that right now. Rebels come away with it. Still caught up in the corner. Pass towards the center here. Might be a chance. One save, and that comes free, and it's in the corner now. Big reaction save from Morgan there as it came sliding across. Now the puck is at center ice, and the Rams are going to go for a change. A little bit of a breather there. Sure was a sigh of relief from Morgan as that was a dangerous play. Started up by the Rebels, and it's dumped in. Morgan comes out, and he dishes it around. Rams trying to get something going the other way. Puck comes out towards the center and into the Rebel zone as they take possession again. And dumped in again, and it's a chase for it. Rams get there first. Sent around by Campbell. And this one coming in on the left side. Shot coming. That's a pad save. Rebels looking to keep it going, and they just can't. Rams able to come away with it. Now they're trying to take it down the other way. Gets by one, and that's Max Engel, who's taken down, trying to start up the offensive attack. And the puck sent all the way around towards the Rams' side for the first icing call of this matchup. As we get ready for a face-off in the Rebel zone, taking a look at when the last time these two teams played, the Rams actually traveled to Las Vegas for this matchup and were able to defeat the Rebels, giving them their first loss at home. So this is surely a heated match we can probably expect ahead of us, as the Rebels are probably coming here looking to repay the favor. Casari with a shot, it gets tipped wide of the net. Nelson trying to dump it back in, but can't get it on his stick, and now it's coming out towards center ice and into the Rams zone. We see the penalty arm going up, and it looks like we might have our first power play of the game.
And that's number 12, Tyler Nelson, who took down one of the UNLV players. He was trying to make a case to the ref that the player might have grabbed his stick, but nonetheless, it is a penalty call, and the away team gets the first power play of the game.
I believe that was a hooking penalty on Nelson there. And now we're going to take a look at how the Rams hold up on this penalty kill. Another team really has an impressive stat when you take a look at their power play success. The Rams only at 9% success when the Rebels are at 15. So both teams looking to improve that stat here tonight. And it looks like the officials are just cleaning up a little bit of the ice here. There's something that they see that they do not like.
Gotta be a hole in the ice or something. Trying to patch that up.
Looks like the officials have gotten that cleared up, and now we're just gonna get ready for the faceoff. Taking the faceoff for the Rebels was Paxton Malone. He wins it for his team. Paxton Malone is a big point contributor. He actually has the most points for his team, 30 points to his name, 16 goals, 14 assists. Right now the Rebels trying to work their power play action. Shot coming from the side there, and that goes wide of the net. Cote able to get it out of the zone, but not able to dump it down. The penalty kill still going on as we have just over 1.5 minutes left in this first power play of the matchup. Rebels holding on to control. Malone has it on his stick, carrying it around Morgan's net. Sends it in, and it's now come out towards the blue line. A little back and forth. Sent across. Trying to get a handle on it. Shot. Pat saved by Morgan. And it's dumped out of the zone by the Rams after that one. So far, so good on this power play. Or on this penalty kill, excuse me. Rams prepping for the next attack as the Rebels start a little bit of quick action. Some long passes across the ice. Coming in on the right side, sent towards the center, near the top of the blue line. Now coming towards the dot. Tried to get sent across near the slot, but intercepted and dumped out of the zone again. And now we only have about 45 seconds left to go in the penalty. Rebels trying to restart here, carrying it through center ice along the right side. Cody Williams dumping it in for his team. Rams get there first. Puck getting tangled up along the boards again. Corey Taylor trying to hang on, but can't, and the Rebels get it back. Sent towards the blue line again. Cameron Fink sends it across along the left side now. Rebels trying to work around this. That's Jacob Morgan holding the man along the wall. Cote trying to give some support. Rebels come away with the puck after that one. Try to send the puck in deeper, deflected, but Rebels still have it. Coming in on the side, Morgan has to stay strong. He blocks one, looking to get the rebound, but can't. Taking one hit, and the puck comes out of the zone as the first penalty of the game, successfully killed by the Rams.
And that was a great penalty kill by the Rams. They gave the away team no ice to work with, resulting in no good shots on Joe Morgan.
No real opportunities there, and I'm sure that's something that the coaching staff of Colorado State is happy to see. Right now, Rams trying to see if they can take it the other way. Nitchin hands it off to Gillis, and right now the puck gets taken away by the Rebels, and they're trying to start it going the other way. Moreno going to send it around with the backhand. It's a little bit going through. We have one stick that went soaring through the air there. Puck now tangled up along the boards. Players trying to come loose with it. Comes out of the zone, and the Rams are going to go for a change. Rebels trying to restart the attack quickly. Can't catch the Rams off guard. Puck sent in towards the corner. Nelson trying to send it towards the teammate, but it comes out of the zone. No icing called, and the Rams have to get ready for another attack. Rebels trying to start up their offense, but can't get the play going, and now the Rams have a chance to start up their own plan. Legere has it on his stick. A little bit of a quick pass to Riley on the left side. Riley carrying it himself, pulls it back, shoots, and the puck goes out of play.
That's not the net you want to hit.
It's the wrong, just a little bit too high.
Well, in the case of Kyle Riley, it was tipped out of there. I'm sure the coach would be kind of mad if that was his actual shot.
Salafos tossed out of the faceoff circle for the Rebels, but nonetheless, they still come away with the faceoff win in their own zone. Rams able to get it back, and they send it further into the corner. Cote trying to race for it, but not able to get his stick on it. Puck at the blue line now. Rams send it back in. Deflected. Comes out of the zone. And it looks like Salafos was injured on that play, and he had to skate off the ice. So he'll get checked out. We hope he's okay. Quickly subbed in for as the Rams trying to get a handle on the puck in their own zone. Sent around Morgan's net. C.J. Nitschen hands it off to North. North carrying it himself, trying to send it out of the zone, but just went up the boards and out of play. And we're going to get ready for a faceoff. Malone to take the faceoff for the Rebels again, but not victorious this time. Puck along the boards, knocked out of the zone. Tried to send it across the ice to Cote, but Rebels intercept and dump it back in off the back glass. Noah Miller trying to hold on to the puck for his team, a little back and forth. And the Rams have it sent across to Cote. Cote on the left side trying to use some of his speed and skill, hands it off to Moreno now. Moreno carrying it around the back of the net. Looking for options, hands it off to Kasari, and the slot shot deflected, laying down his body, and it looks like he took the full force of that shot. And we're going to stop play, make sure he's okay.
Not exactly sure where the puck hit him, but nonetheless he is in pain, which was why we have the stoppage of play.
It looked like he was holding his head area when he went down, but he's trying to crawl off the ice, and it makes you wonder if it hit him lower in the body. That is Sean Plonsky who took the hit, laying down his body for that shot. He's going to get... Looks like it... If we're speculating. Didn't look like he was putting any weight on his left foot. So something in that probably upper leg area. Sarius sends it around as we have the play restarted again. The trainers are going to look at Plonsky, and we'll hope to see him back out on the ice tonight. Right now the puck a little back and forth between a couple players. Shot coming off the side, and that's blocked off the boards again. Can't keep it in the zone. Now it's a race to the puck going down the other way. Morgan going to play it on his stick. And Rebels applying pressure in this Rams defensive end, just trying to get an offensive attack going, and they get the possession. Now they're trying to see if they can get the shots off. Setting up their play, carrying it into the slot. Man goes down, and you see the penalty arm go up, and there's the whistle. That's going to be the second penalty of the night for the Rams with 10:30 left to go in the period.
And that's number 22, Max Engel, accidentally just getting the player's feet instead of the puck, tripping him up, causing the penalty to be called on him.
And puck sent across the blue line now. Eric Williams sent it in a little bit deeper. Puck in the corner now towards Malone. Malone in the faceoff circle. He's going to lose his footing going down. Puck tangled up in the corner now. Both teams just trying to get their sticks on it. And it's back out to Williams. He sends it right back where it came from. Williams on the blue line now, trying to send it in towards the pass right next to Morgan. Play is shut down and it's sent out of the zone. Puck at center ice. Cote applying a little bit of pressure before Williams is going to try and reset the attack. Puck sent in towards the center, and it's knocked near the boards now. Sent off the glass, but not out of the zone yet. And that's Campbell, who's going to use his stick to get out of the zone and make the Rebels restart. Just about halfway of this second penalty. Already taken off the clock. 1 minute to go. Rebels going for a switch. And here they go again. And it looks like they're going to have a little bit of a slip up on that pass there, and the Rams can have a little more time taken off the clock as Campbell even able to get a shot off. Now 40 seconds left to go in the penalty. Hooks in along the boards. Rams applying some good pressure, not allowing them to get in the zone for a good 20 or 30 seconds there, but now that they come in, that pass goes wide to the net. Campbell able to send it out of the zone yet again. Looking pretty good on the penalty kill right now for Colorado State. And the Rebels are going to dump that in, and the Rams are going to hold on to this one, and they dump that out of the zone, and the final 10 seconds of the power play are just going to tick down. 5 seconds now, and Engel's ready to get out of the box. Cote able to even get his stick on it for a brief moment, and now the Rams are back to full strength as the Rebels are trying to get the attack going again. Puck along the boards. Rams come away with it. Riley plowing down one man, trying to get through. He still has the puck on his stick, tried to get the pass off to Jacob Morgan, but wasn't able to connect. Rebels trying to get it out of their zone, and it's backhanded out. Carried in through the right side now. Morgan has to stay on his feet. Puck goes wide of the net, sent along the boards. Lots of physical aggression we're seeing throughout this first period. 7:50 left to go. Still no goals scored. Not even some big opportunities generated for either side, but with speed coming down, glove save from Morgan with the shot from Zach Lawson.
We saw helmetless Kyle Riley skate off the ice. Just look like anyone went to pick up the helmet yet, though.
And it looks like the Rebels are trying to get this attack going. Again, a shot coming off Morgan's pad. He's looking to hold on to his right post there. Rebels along the blue line, shot coming again, looking for the deflections, going off the back glass. Rebels still holding on. Again towards the blue line, another shot coming off the skate of Nelson. That's along the boards again. Puck tangled up in the corner. Players trying to break it free, and they do. Moreno trying to get it out of the zone, and he does. But Cameron Fink, the counterpart number 11, sends it back in, and the Rams reset. As far as that injury report from earlier, Sean Plonsky, I believe he might be out of the game. He was just seen being escorted towards the locker room, and that's not a good sign to see. And we hope he's okay, and we wish him a speedy recovery if we are going to see him back out on the ice tonight. Rebels getting the offense started on the other side, but the Rams take it away, and they want to start an attack of their own. Rebels not going to make it easy, though. Puck at center ice, trying to be carried in on the right side. North trying to apply some pressure. Tristan Mayer was trying to carry it in, but had it knocked away. Puck in the corner again. Puck comes loose. Rams come away with it. Try to send it out of the zone off the glass, but knocked out of the zone and out of play. After the faceoff, puck is now at center ice. The Rebels are looking to get the first tally up on the board. Rebels working it around, and this one knocked off the back glass. Rebels racing towards this one again. That was Connor Hetzel. Puck coming towards the center, looking to get the shot off, but can't. Rams doing a good job of tangling up the play, but it looks like we're going to get another penalty call.
Yet another penalty against the home team, the Colorado State Rams, with 5 minutes and 44 seconds remaining in this period.
That's going to be their third penalty of the period. They've killed two so far. Would almost, they almost made it look easy, and we're going to see if they can do that a third time. Rams win the defensive faceoff and send it out of the zone immediately, and the penalty kill begins. Rebels starting their attack coming down the right side. With speed, sends it back along the boards, sent towards the center near the top of the blue line. Now on the opposite faceoff circle. Sent in deep, trying to get the shot, saved by Morgan, and now it's being carried the other way. This might be a chance for Cote. He's got a one-on-one situation. He's able to work around the stick. The shot goes wide of the net, though. 1:20 left to go in this penalty. Malone carrying it down with a lot of speed on the right side. And he's going to lose the puck in the process, but he's able to get his stick on it to get it back towards DeAndre Jordan, or John, excuse me. Malone on the right side, shot coming, and Morgan's going to swallow that up. Get ready for another faceoff with just under a minute left to go in this power play.
There were two good chances on either side. That last shot that just came in on Morgan was tipped. And a few seconds before that, Sam Cote, realizing that he had a one-on-one opportunity on the penalty kill and just taking his shot, just the puck barely missing wide, though.
Shot coming, another big save from Morgan. Rebels looking for the rebound shot. Backhander, another save, deflected, and it's now behind the net. Center around the boards, that's Eric Williams. Sends it back in deep. Puck along the boards again. Coming around the other side now. Along the blue line, shot coming from Williams. That one bounced off Morgan's. Looked like that might have been his stick hand there. Puck came out of the zone briefly, but the Rebels bring it back in. That's Eric Williams, yet again, being involved on this play. Puck along the boards. Rams trying to get it out of the zone. And it looks like it just briefly came out, and the official's going to call the offsides. Seconds left to go in the power play. 3:58 left to go in the period. Faceoff's going to be just outside the Rams zone. Jordan Ray taking the faceoff for the Rebels, and they come away successful on that one. Sent in deep towards the center, deflected. Puck still in play, though. Sent around the boards. Connor Hetzel on the right side. He's going to take a hit in the process, but he's able to hand it off towards his teammate. Sent around the back, trying to backhand it towards the slot, but Morgan's going to cover that one up.
That was a good job by Joe Morgan to be able to check around his surroundings, the play happening behind the net, and cut that puck off from going anywhere in front of him.
The Rams kill yet another third penalty tonight. They're looking pretty good on this penalty kill, I'd say, right now.
That's one way to boost your stats.
Puck comes out towards center ice. That's Rosenthal on the left side. Gonna try and dump it in for his team and try and buy some time. Sent around along the boards by the Rebels. Carrying it out of the zone now. Off the boards on the right side is Colin Robin. He's gonna take a hit in the process. Sent back towards the blue line. Shot coming, deflected. That one goes wide of the net. Rosenthal racing towards the puck. He's gonna get there first. Rams scrambling to try and get a clear possession of it. Puck tangled up near the point. Sent back in, no offsides play, never left the zone. Kasaria sends it around for Nelson, back to Kasaria, who now leaves it for Legere. Rebels trying to get it back as it's sent out of the zone. It's a race for it as the Rams are going to go for a change. Sent in deep. And then the Rams is trying to get it back. Puck at center ice, sent in now off the boards into the Rams zone. Nelson trying to play some defense. Joseph, who has it on his stick now, looking for options, trying to get it out of the zone. He's going to lose his footing. Puck sent towards the center. Player's a little bit lost looking for the puck, and now it comes loose and out towards center ice and into the Rebel zone. Rebels is trying to get something going here. Neither team really being able to generate some amazing chances, but we might see one right here. Pass coming towards the slot. Tried to leave it for his man in the middle, but not able to get the shot off. That's two shots that weren't able to connect for the Rebels there. Puck near the blue line now. Shot, that one goes wide of the net. Center around the boards again. A few more hits being dished out by the Rams. Along the boards once more, coming out towards the slot. This might be a chance here. Shot coming, that one's another save from Morgan. He's holding up well so far. Buck in the corner now behind Morgan's net, while Jacob Morgan is trying to fend off a couple Rebels. Rebels get it back and trying to restart the offense with just about 1:20 left to go in the period as we get a whistle. Looks like it was going to be offside.
And that was about a good 2 minutes in that Rams defensive zone. At that point, you might want to just get the puck out of there. Although you do not want to get an icing because you want that fresh change.
Looks like both players tossed out of the faceoff circle. You don't see that too often.
It was a little bit funny at first. Millar started mocking him, and then he got tossed out right afterwards.
Rams carrying it out of their own zone now at center ice. Puck dumped in. Rams have to go and chase this one. Sent around the boards. Cote able to get it on his stick, but it's taken away. Puck near the center red line again. North sends it in. Cote takes a hit, but he's able to dump the puck in. CJ Nitchin racing towards this one. He's going to fend off Thomas Harrison of the Rebels. Trying to get the shot from the blue line was Miller, but it was blocked on the way there. Bryce Woodward carrying it in on the right side. Backhands it towards the center. Not able to get the shot off as the puck was flying through the air. Not out of play yet. Just about 30 seconds left to go in the period. CJ Nitchin on the right side. Dumping it in for his team as the Rams looks like they're going to go for a change. 20 seconds now left to go in the period as the Rebels just going to get this puck in their own zone. That's Foundos trying to apply some pressure. 10 seconds left to go now. Rebels using a lot of long pass plays, but it doesn't look like it's going to pay off right now as the final seconds of this first period tick down. And so after one period of play, we are scoreless. Both teams at zero. Three power play chances for the Rebels, all killed off by the Rams. We have two more periods of action coming at you. You're watching Colorado Sports TV. We'll be right back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. You're watching Colorado Sports TV. I'm Leechus Castro here with Tristan Anderson. We've got all this Colorado State hockey action covered for you. Colorado State's currently taking on the University of Nevada, Las Vegas. Right now, the score is tied at zeros after one period of play. Still got two more periods of hockey left to go, though. Taking a look at what we saw last period, the Rams had three penalties that they killed off successfully. Well done to them on the penalty kill. I'm sure Joe Morgan is happy about that one. Tristan, as far as what we need to see change, if anything, what do you think the Rams are looking to improve on after the last period?
Well, so far the Rams have done really well in their penalty kill. The only problem, though, is that they keep getting those penalties. They need to maintain their discipline to be able to have the puck in their favor instead of having to dump it down the ice every time that they're on the penalty kill.
Taking a look at the main differences that we see between the teams, the Rebels got 16 shots during last period. The Rams only got five. So the Rams are probably needing to step up their offensive game right now, and they're not being able to do that right now as this is a bouncing puck and around the net, and play is blown dead as the net is knocked loose. That was a stressful situation in the first seconds of this period.
And that puck went right over top of Joe Morgan, right through the crease. He was just able to keep it out of there. I'm not really sure if it was much of him as it was forces working for him. And that net just got kicked right off of the goal line, which caused a stoppage of play.
We're going to get ready for another face-off here. Getting ready for a face-off. Looks like it's just going to be right outside the Rams' defensive zone here. 19:44 left to go in the period. Got so much action in these first few seconds. Rams come away with a face-off win. A little back and forth. Nelson not able to get a good handle on it. Rebels take it away, passing across. Shot going wide of the net. Rebels just not able to connect on that the way they wanted to. Another backhander shot right in front of Morgan. He stops that one as well. Two good saves from Morgan on the panic defense that he just had to perform right there. The Rebels take it away again. This might be a chance. Backhander, bouncing puck in front of him. Rebels looking for the rebound, but can't get it. Another beautiful save from Morgan. Puck now tangled up in the corner. The action really is picking up right now. Players looking to knock the puck free. Rebels trying to continue the offense, and they do. Shot coming from the blue line, and now it's being taken down the other way by the Rams. Rams going for a change. And Ben Joseph now has it on his stick, backhands it towards Thrushley. He tries to send it in deep. Corey Taylor racing towards it for his team. Moreno gets tangled up with his opposite, Cameron Fink. And we're going to have a whistle. Looks like this might be the first penalty on UNLV. Las Vegas has been on the power play for all three of the penalties in this game, but now they're going to get their first time on the penalty kill. Good chance to see how the Rams perform on the power play tonight. Kyle Riley to take the faceoff for the Rams. But the Rebels come away with the win and on the faceoff in their own zone. They're taking down the other way, trying to get a shorthanded opportunity. Taylor shoving him off the puck. Riley even going to throw in an extra hit there. Puck now at center ice, 1:45 left to go in this penalty. Puck sent around behind Joe Morgan's net. Rams looking to set up their power play offense. Carried through center ice by Riley. He's going to lose a little bit of a handle on it, trying to keep it alive as Nitchin. Puck tangled up along the boards again. Heads it back to Taylor at the blue line. He's going to skate it across, trying to get the pass towards the center. Might be a rebound shot, and that's another save coming in from Eric Edison, who's in net right now for UNLV.
That was a good chance by the Rams there on that on the power play. They got a few shots on that on the UNLV goalie to maybe put his focus even more into the game.
Rams win the offensive faceoff here. Kasaria has it at the blue line. He passes it in further, tried to get the pass across, and it's back to Kasaria, and he loses the handle of the puck at the blue line. It comes out of the zone. Rams have to reset, take more time off the clock. 1 minute left to go in the power play. Looking to reset. Joseph tries to get it off to Moreno. Buck still at center ice. Nelson on the right side, dumping it in for his team to go and chase. Edison tries to send it out of the zone, and he actually does. Bouncing off the glass, coming towards Morgan. It's a race towards the puck. Morgan going to use his own stick to get involved. Puck at center ice and sent back into the Rams zone. So far, not looking too good on the Rams power play as well. Las Vegas doing a good job on the penalty kill. 30 seconds in the Rams' first power play. Long pass across, able to get it to Gillis on this left side. Gillis trying to use his one-man skills, but it's knocked away from him. The Rebels have it on their sticks. Just looking to dump it out of the zone. Rams able to interrupt that play, but still taking more time off the clock. Less than 10 seconds to go in the power play. Puck tangled up along the board, and now it finally comes loose. Thomas Harrison carrying it on his stick, sends it back. And it's sent out of the zone as the power play comes to a close. And we have the icing call. Off the faceoff, puck was headed towards the goal, but the Rebels knock it away. Now it's a race for the puck going the other way. on the left side, trying to get the centering pass, but not able to connect, and the net is knocked loose after, I believe that was Jordan Ray who collided with the net, fully sending it towards the back glass.
That was a big hit with the net there. Foley brought his shoulder into it as well. He didn't want to hit it. He was a little frustrated that he was going into it, just decided to put his full force.
You'd think the net said something to him. .16:20 left to go in the period. Rebels come away with another face-off win at center ice. Trying to send it in, but Grayson North intercepts that one, sends it the other way. Rebels have it back on their sticks. That's Eric Williams sending it around the boards for his team. And it's kicked back in near the blue line. Riley trying to work his way out of the corner. You see a lot of those one-man plays from him. Lots of players colliding, pushing and shoving along the corner there. Backhander shot goes wide of the net. North looking to get it out of his own zone now. Sends it out towards center ice, but the Rebels have it on their sticks again. It's Kazupski trying to apply some pressure. Riley gets it back on his stick on the right side, gets the shot off, and it's a save, looking to get the rebound chance, but not successful. Good save from Madison. Getting ready for a face-off in this UNLV zone. And the Rebels have Kazupski in the face-off circle, facing off against Millar. Rebels come away with the win. And we see a lot of these high-speed plays from Cody Williams, number 9, looking to get the centering pass, but not successful. It looks like the net came loose, and Morgan was trying to fix it so that the play wouldn't stop, but the official blew the play dead.
Bet he is more glad that the play did stop in his favor.
Another face-off win by the Rebels. Kazupski trying to find some options. Puck along the boards again. Rebels able to get a nice few passes going. Shot coming from the blue line. That one soars over. It goes off the back glass. Players again coming near the corner. Kazupski again behind Morgan's net, trying to carry it around himself. And puck comes loose after a big hit. Chance at the blue line now. Sent in deep towards the corner. Behind Morgan's net again. Centering pass. Shot blocked. And it comes out of the zone. Another good defensive stance by the Rams. Hit along the boards. Puck sent around. Behind Morgan's net again. Rams just trying to get out of their own zone. And turned over again in their own zone. Shot wide of the net. Another big opportunity wasted. Another centering pass and can't connect. Las Vegas just trying to get something going. Another centering pass. Another shot not even being able to be taken. Puck along the boards and knocked out of play. Now 14-14 left to go in the period. If you're on this Las Vegas side, you've got to be frustrated at the opportunities that you just were not able to come away with right now. Justin, if you're going through something like that in the game, what is the solution? I mean, they're winning the turnovers in the offensive zone, but they're just not getting the shots on goal when they need to.
Well, I think that was a great opportunity by UNLV. Although it did not turn into a goal, it was still a great scoring chance, and the more and more you get those great scoring chances, the more likely it's bound to happen eventually. And that was more of a sloppy play coming from the Rams to pass that puck right in front of the net. I'm sure Joe Morgan wasn't happy with his team about that.
Right now, it looks like we're going to get a penalty call. It looked like it was going to be a possible high-sticking call. And it's going to be a penalty on UNLV. That's going to be their second penalty of this period and of the night. Saw the officials high five. Possibly congratulating each other on a call. So the Rams are on another power play opportunity. All power plays have been unsuccessful so far tonight as we are still scoreless. Rams trying to set up their five-man play with the advantage here. 1:40, 20 seconds off the power play. Kyle Riley on the left side. Gets around a couple men, sending the puck in, but Rebels intercept and send it out of the zone. More time taken off the clock. Colorado State has to reset and generate a game plan here. They make a couple changes. Cote able to get around one. Gets it across the blue line, but offside.
Sam Cote showing off his moves, swerving around the UNLV's penalty kill line. Although he ended up being offsides, just taking an extra second to put that puck over the blue line than his team might have expected.
Moreno to take the faceoff for the Rams, and he comes away with the win on that one. This area facing a little bit of pressure from this Rebels defense in their own zone. 1 minute left to go now in the power play. Rams is trying to get something connected, trying to start the play going the other way, but it gets lost in the passing lane, and we have the icing call. See, number 10 for the Rebels, Salafos, is back in the game. He took a hit earlier in the first period, had to skate off the ice, but he is back out there now, so glad to see he is okay. Rams trying to continue their power play opportunity, just about 35 seconds left to go. Onside play, shot coming from the left side, deflected, goes off the glass. Joseph on the right side near the blue line, sends it back around for his teammate Casaria, but the Rebels get there first, but lose the puck in the process. Back to Joseph near the blue line. Passing back to Casaria. Shot towards the center. Scores! Rams come away with the first goal of the game on a power play.
And that one-timer right in front of the net. Tanner Gillis, number 23 for the Rams, finds a corner and puts it away.
With 12:10 left to go in the second period, the Rams come away with the first goal and power play goal of the game on the fifth penalty of the night. The assist going to Tino Moreno on that play. That is Moreno's 11th point to his name. Rebels trying to get the attack going the other way, see if they can return the favor. Pass coming towards the center and a reaching back leg save from Morgan. Just barely able to stop that one from getting by him.
We saw Tito Moreno get his 11th point just now of the season. As they say, score your number. Number 11 gets his 11th point.
As far as Tanner Gillis, that was actually his 10th point, so he has now reached double digits for his team. Rams come away with a faceoff in their own zone and looking to take it the other way. Cote trying to take it down the other way with speed, but he gets tangled up in the process. Puck sent around the boards behind Idison's net. Along the right side, Rebels still trying to just hang on defensively. Rams trying to keep the pressure up. Puck comes out of the zone. Handing on, speed on this Rebels attack, and it goes wide of the net along the boards again. Puck comes loose. Rebels able to get it back on the offense again. Rams just keep turning it over in their own zone, and that's something that they have to clean up if they don't want to give these Rebels any unnecessary chances. Puck sent off the boards towards center ice. Hote on the right side dumps it in towards Idison, who's not going to hold on to that one, just leave it for his teammate. Rebels start the attack from their own zone. Handing it off on this left side. And that's Williams. Cody Williams on this left side trying to get the centering pass, and it bounces off Morgan and is sent out of the zone. Cody Williams with the pass towards the center. Eric Williams to retrieve it now. As the Rebels are getting their five-man plan set up. Rams able to get it back, though. On the offensive turnover, Gillis loses it in the process. Rebels get it back. Rebels soaring that pass into the Rams zone. Nelson sends it around, but only for Salafos to be there for the Rebels. Pass back towards blue line, and it's now deflected out of play. Just under 10 minutes to go. If you're just now joining us, you're watching ColoradoSports.tv. I'm Leto's Couch here with Tristan Anderson. We've got all the action covered for you right now. Like I said, if you're just now joining us, the Rams just scored a power play goal not too long ago, which was the first goal of the game. So Colorado State leading UNLV 1-0 with 9:52 left to go in this game. Or excuse me, this period. Shot coming from the blue line, blocked on the way there. Rams trying to turn it the other way. Possible 3-on-3 situation. Left side across the blue line, sent off the backboards. Puck sent around again. That's Rosenthal trying to generate an opportunity for his team. He goes down in the process, but the Rams still have the puck. Rebels trying to take it away. Comes towards the slot. Rams trying to take possession there, if any place in this offensive zone. Comes in and out, and the Rams had to react to the offside play, and now the Rebels can possibly have a chance of their own. Looking for the long pass towards center ice, and they connect. Looking for another one. They connect another one. That's Muller on the left side. Shot. That one goes wide of the net. Chance coming from this right side possibly now. Looking for the centering pass again. We're seeing a lot of these passes towards the center, and Las Vegas is a lot of the time getting the man there, just not able to get the stick on the puck.
Here comes number 17 for the Rams, CJ Nitchin. He skated off a few minutes ago with a skate malfunction. Just saw him walking back over to the bench not too long ago. Good to see him back in this game. He's a great force for the Rams offense.
Rebels come away with a defensive face-off win. Eric Williams sending it out of the zone. Back towards the other end for an icing call. We're going to go right back where we just were. .847 left to go in the period. Faceoff coming in this Rebel zone. Kyle Riley to take the faceoff for the Rams. Comes away with a win. Shot from Nitchin right off of that. And it's a big save from Madison. Riley trying to come away with another faceoff win, and he does. North from the center. Shot coming and another big save. Rams starting to start their own offensive pressure right now after getting outshot 16-5 last period. Looks like it's starting to turn the other way for them. Rebels come away with a faceoff win this time. Not able to get three in a row for the Rams. Rams working from along the boards here. CJ Nitchin going to apply pressure as it comes to Williams, who's able to hand it off, and it's now speeding down the other way into this Colorado State zone. Mayer trying to get the centering pass, backhanding it. Puck a little tangled up, a shot coming from the side, looking for a rebound, another rebound save from Morgan. Possible opportunity for the Rebels there.
Joe Morgan's faced a lot of shots in this game so far, and he stayed strong on all of them. There's rebounds, shots right from the middle, and he's been able to, so far, put a stop to every single one he's faced.
Morgan is just an impressive goaltender for this Rams defense. I mean, you take a look at him, especially when he was playing against Colorado. He was coming away with over 40 saves a game. And that's just something you got to give him credit for. Moreno trying to carry it in himself. Turned over. Caseri with a shot and another save. Amidison looking for the rebound chance but not able to capitalize. Still bouncing puck around. And finally covered up in between the legs of Amidison. Another faceoff coming in the Rebel zone here. 7:47 left to go in this period. Rams trying to get something going, and the puck comes out of the zone and a little bit of confusion, and now the Rams have to reset. Puck comes back in the zone, but the Rebels trying to get a breakaway chance, almost were able to connect that pass, but it was one deflection of a defensive stick that was able to break up that play and get it towards Morgan to cover it up.
One of the referees having to come between the opposing team players.
Faceoff coming in the Colorado State zone. Rebels come away with another faceoff win, looking to take a shot from this right side. Pass coming towards the middle, but the Rams knock it back towards the boards. Coming near the corner now. Another big hit. And the puck comes out towards center ice. Rebels have to reset. Jacob Morgan gets it on his stick for the Rams, and now they're trying to turn it the other way. Engel losing his footing for just a moment, but holds on and carries it into the zone. Puck along the boards now, and the Rams trying to hold on, but the Rebels knock it out of the zone, but Corey Taylor knocks it right back in. Mason holds it behind his net, and now the Rebels are going to start from deep in their own zone. It's Kazubski carrying in on the left side. Gets around one. Excuse me, that was actually Connor Hetzel, who just had the offside play. Rebels come away with another faceoff, but turned over in their own zone. This might be a chance coming down the other way. That was Max Engel who had the opportunity, Max Legere who had that opportunity, but lost his footing in the rush. But it's going to result in a penalty against the Rebels and another power play chance for the Rams. Rams come away with a power play face-off win. Corey Taylor hands it off to Cote. Cote trying to get the centering pass, and they do. Shot from Nitschen, saved. And now it's back near the boards, trying to carry it in towards the center is Riley. Now the Rebels get it on their stick. Puck comes out of the zone. Colorado State has to reset their offensive attack. 1:35 left to go in the penalty. Turned over again in their own zone. This has got to be frustrating for this Rams coaching staff. And the Rams get it back, and it looks like this is going to be a penalty. So as Las Vegas went on their third penalty of the night, the Rams are going on their fourth now, so we're going to see some four-on-four action. For about 1:29 left to go in that Colorado State penalty, and then UNLV will have a short power play opportunity.
And just a bad turnover by the Rams that ends up causing the penalty to happen after one of the UNLV players takes over the puck. Noah Miller in the box for 2 minutes.
Right now the Rebels starting from their own zone. Looks like they're going to slow it down a little bit, take some more time off the clock, and get organized really quickly. Starting from their own side, passed off towards the left side towards Williams. Pass towards the center. This might be a chance. Shot coming. Scores! The 4-on-4 opportunity comes through for UNLV.
And that's as clean as a shot as you can get. As I was saying before, these guys in practice, they were making every single shot that they wanted to. They were picking the corner and shooting in that exact spot. To be able to do that during a high-speed game is something that shows great skill. And the UNLV player just showed that. I'm sorry, who scored again?
That was number 25, Vassell Asaf. So with 5:27 left to go in the period, the score is now tied at 1, and we still have 4-on-4 hockey. Puck sent across the blue line now. Rebels trying to see if they can get another one. Centering pass deflected, and it goes along the boards now near the blue line again. Sent in deep towards the corner, towards Oler. Along the boards again. Rebels trying to send it back, but it comes out of the zone. 20 seconds left to go in the Colorado State penalty before they have to get back on the penalty kill. Coming in on the left side with speed is Fink. Comes back towards the blue line, sent across towards the opposite corner. Corey Taylor trying to get a handle on it for his team. Cote now for the Rams, gets taken away. 30 seconds of a power play for the Rebels. Come towards the blue line again, Williams sends it back in. Sent across towards the center, back towards Williams. Near the top of the blue line, shot coming, saved by Morgan. Fifteen seconds left to go in this power play opportunity for the Rebels. Faceoff coming in the Rams zone. 4:16 left to go in the period. Again, we are tied at 1 after the 4-on-4 goal that Asaf just scored for his team on the Rebels side. Rebels have to go and retrieve the puck in their own zone. As the final seconds of the Colorado State penalty tick down. And we're back to 5-on-5 hockey now with just under 4 minutes left to go in the period. Rebels still on the attack on this left side. Rams trying to hold on defensively after just giving up one, not wanting to give up another. Puck along the boards a lot tonight. And looking for the centering pass now, coming from behind the net. Nelson able to break up that play, and Riley has it on his stick for the Rams. Trying to turn it the other way. A lot of turnovers that the Rams are trying to avoid, like that one. Rebels get it back. Thomas Harrison was trying to carry it in, but we got a whistle blown. We're going to get ready for a faceoff in this Rams defensive end. Rebels win the offensive faceoff, trying to get the passing and a shot, but it's deflected by another Rebel. Joseph carrying it out of the zone, hands it off to Rosenthal, who backhands it into the zone. Joseph trying to keep the pressure up, but puck comes out towards center ice, and this might be a possible chance for the Rebels as the race towards the puck. North gets his stick on it first for the Rams, but the Rebels still have possession, carrying from behind the net, looking for the centering pass, blocked on the way there. They still have possession. Sent in towards the side, towards Paxton Malone. Sends it back towards the blue line now, sent across. Passed in deep. Back again, sent across the blue line. Shot coming, deflected. A few times on the way there, looking for the rebound opportunity. Crashing into the net, comes loose. We're going to have a stoppage to play.
That was a good defensive stick by the Rams defense to be able to get that stick up in there and block that shot, take off a lot of the power, although it did mix up things a bit for Joe Morgan. That puck stayed out of the net.
.243 left to go in the period. After two goals scored, one from the Rams earlier this period on a power play, and Rebels were able to answer back later. And we're tied at one. Rebels come away with the faceoff at center ice, and that's sent towards Morgan, who bounces it off his pad, and it comes near the boards. Puck going behind Morgan's net again. It's a race towards the puck, and again it gets tangled up near the glass here. CJ Nitschen getting tangled up there. Another turnover in their own zone. Rebels still able to maintain possession. Sent across the blue line now. Back to Williams. Taking one hit, losing a little bit of the puck control that he had. Sending a little bit deeper. Rams trying to get some control. Cote is able to get it off. The angle here, tries to get the shot off. That one goes wide of the net. And it looks like we get another whistle. Looks like it's going to be a penalty.
You saw a guy in the yellow jacket jumping up, saying hi to his friend.
What a guy.
Not sure the friend's name, but hello to you.
So that's another UNLV penalty. So now the penalties are tied at four per team, and it's another power play for the Rams. Cote coming in on the right side. Sends it across to Riley. Riley looking for options. Sends it back towards the blue line, towards Miller. Gets it back to Riley. A little quick 1-2 shot. Not able to get the glove save. Rebound opportunity. That one's also shut down. Caseria able to get that rebound shot. Sends it back towards the blue line. Barely comes out of the zone. And the official blows the offsides whistle.
That was one of the best chances we've seen in this game that did not result in a goal. Brian Caseria able to get that rebound, but the goalie for UNLV just puts his body out there and is able to make that save.
Rebels come away with the win on the penalty kill, and it's sent around along the boards. Rams have to go and get this one. Just 1:15 left to go in their penalty, their power play opportunity, but there's only 1:02 left to go in this period. So if they're not able to score on this man advantage for the rest of the period, they will have a few seconds of a power play going into the third period. Joseph carrying it through the center. Now onto the left side. And carrying himself, hands it off to Gillis. Gillis with a shot. That one gets deflected. Goes off the glass, but not out of play. Play continues, coming in from the right side. Backhands it towards the net, looking for the rebound opportunity. Shot scores! The Rams get two on a power play.
And the Rams really turning it up on their power play. We haven't seen too much from them recently. But that's number 23, Tanner Gillis, once again.
That's going to be his second goal of the night. And with 33.6 seconds left to go in the second period, the Rams regain the lead.
Colorado State Power Play Gale! Scored by number 23.
Rebels trying to get something going in the last seconds of this second period. Puck is tangled up behind Morgan's net. Rams just trying to hold on defensively. 5 seconds left, and the net comes down as the shot's taken. That one literally went over the net with 2 seconds left. As it's like a couple players went crashing down, and Morgan was, you know, a little goalie cocoon, if you will.
You can't cage him. That's Joe Morgan.
Again, Morgan's net has to be reset. That's probably the fourth or fifth time this period.
It's a bit scary when you're standing there in goal and all of a sudden you're just trapped.
Net comes crashing down on you.
And you're paying attention to the play as well. That puck's out in front. You're not looking at that net falling behind you.
Sure, not many people expect the thing that they're supposed to protect comes back to attack them. It's like the official having to have a discussion with CJ Nitchin and Victor Brask. And the final seconds of the period tick down, and after two periods of play, Colorado State has taken the lead 2-1 over the UNLV Rebels. We will be right back with the third period of action. We're going to take a quick break. You're watching Colorado Sports TV. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. You're watching ColoradoSports.tv. I'm Leechus Castro here with Tristan Anderson. We've got all the action covered for you tonight. After two periods of play, Colorado State is leading UNLV 2-1 after a pair of power play goals in the second period. As far as what we've seen so far this game, there were no goals scored in the first period after three penalties for the Rams. Then UNLV had a few penalties of their own in the second period, and Rams were able to capitalize on two of them. Excuse me, there's actually four penalties towards that UNLV side. But yes, the Rams came away with two power play goals, and the Rebels were able to answer one of those goals with a 4-on-4 goal that they were able to score during that period. So 2-1 is where we're at right now. Rebels are playing from behind, looking to see if they can get back into this one. And a shot coming from the blue line. That's deflected on the way there. Rebels trying to keep that offensive attack going early in this third period. Rams trying to get a handle on it and take it out of the zone. Tristan, what were some of the problems that we were seeing on the Rams side last period?
The Rams just kind of need that discipline. They started off the game with a bunch of penalties that luckily went in their favor. Although the 4-on-4 ended up having them get that goal scored against them when they could have stayed on that power play. So I would say just keeping those penalties to a minimum, as they have in that second period more than they did in the first. If they just keep that discipline going, then they will be able to have those offensive chances more in their zone instead of having to dump that puck down.
And taking a look at that Vegas side, they're having what you might say a lot of opportunities now before this period got started. 29 shots to their team, just only one of them going in the back of the net. Does that say anything about what their offense is able to be putting out right now, or maybe what they're not being able to produce as far as on the attack?
Well, that's it. That says a lot about Joe Morgan, because this is a team that can put the puck where they want, and you could tell with the amount of players that they have in the 20-point range. And Joe Morgan is able to stop most of these goals.
Yeah, well, it looks like he might.
Most of these shots.
Pulls away with a save on that
one. As he does right there.
That was a 3-on-1 situation, and Morgan's able to come away with a huge save, maintaining the lead for this Colorado State team. What a play from him. And that almost emphasizes what we're talking about as far as that UNLV side is, you know, at the same time. all these chances but not able to get it past Morgan. Right now the puck is along the boards again. Rebels trying to keep this attack going as the puck comes out towards center ice and into the Rebel zone. Rebels playing from their own end. It gets towards Kazupski. Comes into the zone as Kazupski loses his footing. Comes out of the zone now, and Rams trying to get it back. That's Cote applying a little bit of pressure, and now it comes in behind Morgan's net. He comes out to play it on his stick. Gets sent around. Rebels get there for that one. Sent back towards the center. Shot coming. That one tipped and out of play. So just about 2 minutes have gone by in this period, and still at the score of 2-1. Faceoff coming in the Rams zone. Rebels come away with another offensive faceoff win. But the puck is knocked out of the zone, and now it's a race between the 11s. Rebels get there first. Rams battling for the puck in this Rebel zone, but Rebels come away with it. UNLV trying to get this offensive attack going. They might on this right side. Shot coming, bouncing off Morgan. Not able to get the rebound opportunity. Rebels looking to keep the pressure on as Noah Miller has it for the Rams. Puck sent out of the zone, and it's a race to that one. No icing called as Edison, the goaltender for the Rebels, comes out to get that. And as Jacob Morgan tried to send that back in, it was tipped and I believe knocked out of play, so we're going to have a faceoff. Faceoff at center ice. Campbell winning that faceoff for his team. Colorado State sending that puck in towards Edison. He's going to use his stick to just pass it along. And a mini collision there at center ice, and now Campbell was able to get it on his stick, who sent it back in towards that Rebel zone as he goes for a change, and the Rebels restart their attack. Pass off towards the center. Corey Taylor able to break up that play, and he dumps it in for his team. And that's Max Legere trying to apply some pressure with the help of Kyle Riley, and it's sent down by the Rebels, but no Rebel in sight to get it, and the Rams take possession in their own zone. Long pass towards the center ice, and that was Campbell who had to take a hit along the way there, and Nelson has it on his stick behind Morgan's net again. Rams working from their own end with speed. On that side is Riley, and he has that puck knocked away from him as the puck comes near the boards again in the Rams defensive zone. Puck sent around behind the boards. Behind Morgan's net and along the boards. Now coming along this left side is Malone. Malone with a shot. That one just off target. Probably knocked along one or two sticks on the way there, and it's out of play. 15:50 left to go in the period. Still 2-1. Rams lead. As far as the shot count from last period, the Rams actually outshot UNLV during the last period, 15-13. However, in total, Las Vegas is still leading this game in the shot department. Still four penalties a squad, so nothing too fancy there, but this might be a fancy shot coming up, passing towards the center. Malone knocked down as he was looking for the shot, and now Miller trying to take it the other way. He gets the pass through to Cote. Cote through the center. Might be a chance for the Rams side now. He's going to knock it off the backboards. Miller trying to get the centering pass, but no one is there for it. Now Malone trying to take it down the other way. Puck is at center ice. This is a one-on-one opportunity. Trying to get around one, and he does. Looking for the backhander. Glutch save from Morgan. Able to react to a huge offensive opportunity on that UNLV side.
One of the better opportunities we've seen of this game, following Brian Casario's opportunity in the second period. Joe Morgan completely stretching out his glove and windmilling that to show off a bit
shot coming off the faceoff. That one goes over Morgan and near the back of the boards there. Moreno trying to help his team out and trying to get it to Joseph. The Rebels take possession again along the boards and in the corner. Send it back towards the blue line. Try to get the centering pass again, but not able to get it on a Rebel stick. We're seeing a lot of that center pass opportunity. Slap shot coming, and that goes off the side of the net. And it looks like we've got a glove and a stick that came off there after the whistle. Looks like the intensity might be rising between the players. Again, when the Rams went to play UNLV on their home turf, they handed them their first loss at home this season. So the Rebels are most likely here to return the favor. Rebels come away with another face-off win. Puck at the blue line. And players getting tangled up as the puck is now broken free and at center ice. Casario is going to dump it in for his team. We see a lot of the dump and chase maneuver from the Rams. That's not uncommon from them. But the Rebels are trying to take this down the other way. Two-on-two opportunity as the Rams are getting more backup. And the puck sent around again. Rebels have it on their sticks near the blue line. Sent in towards that left side. Shot coming deflected off of Morgan. Looking for a rebound shot. Able to work it through the legs, but Morgan comes away with another glove save.
That was an in-between-the-leg shot.
That's not something you see too often in this level of hockey.
It's definitely something the players practice. It's not something you see too often in a game. If you have a good opportunity and you decide to do that, your coach could get mad. Although sometimes you can turn a bad opportunity into a good one by fooling the goalie with that move.
Rebels looking to see if they can get a good opportunity right now. You see Moeller trying to get that pass in, but Morgan covers it up. We get ready for another faceoff. 13:41 now left to go in the period. Rams still leading 2-1. Taking a look at the goal scorers, Tanner Gillis is the man for Colorado State who has both of the goals, one away from a hat trick. Looking at the assists, we've had Ben Joseph, Tito Moreno, and Corey Taylor assisting on these goals. A little bit of a scramble here on this Rams side as the Rebels going for another shot. Bouncing puck. Morgan comes away with another save. And another rebound shot. Scores! The Rebels tie it up with 13:24 left to go in the third period.
Once again, I've said before, this team is able to pick the corner that they want and fire it in that exact position. Joe Morgan was ready for that, and he had most angles blocked, but he was just beaten by a great shot.
Now tied at 2. It's going to be interesting to see how both. It's going to be interesting to see how both teams respond to this. Looks like the goal goes to Paxton Malone, assisted by number 3, John Moeller, on that Rebel side. Puck again in this Rams zone as Rebels scrambling for it, and the Rams just trying to get some possession, see if they can generate an offense of their own. Working from their own zone is Jacob Morgan as he hands it off to Gillis, back to Morgan. Morgan at center ice, going to carry it in himself on the left side and dump it around the boards. Trying to leave it for Gillis. Rebels trying to come away with the puck on their own. And that is Hetzel, who's able to get it out of the zone. But the Rams are able to retreat, and Morgan's going to come in hot, and the Rams get it back on their sticks. Pass towards center ice, and that's Joseph carrying it on the left side. Tried to get it back to Moreno, but the Rebels take it back again. Pass towards center ice once more. A little 1-2 play. And now that's Williams able to get it off to Kasupski, and that's a shot, and that's another big save as it gets deflected out of play.
Joe Morgan was just barely able to get his glove on that shot, keeping it out of the net. We saw a little bit of a spark there from the Rebels coming into that offensive zone. they kept working as hard as they could, it looked like. And they came out with a great offensive opportunity.
Seems like the Rebels might have taken that goal as a spark of energy, and right now they're using it on the offensive side, dumping it into the Rams zone again. We're seeing a lot more quick speed plays from this Rebels offense. They're trying to use a lot of their foot racing abilities to take control of the puck right now. That's Rosenthal, who's going to take a hit at center ice, and the Rebels take the puck back. Asaf, who had the 4-on-4 goal in the second period, hands it off to Cameron Fink. Fink sends it down one more to DeAndre John. Rams get the puck back, and now Legier sends it down the ice. But the Rebels taking a hit as the Rams get the puck back on their sticks. Jacob Morgan trying to send it in, but it gets blocked on the way there. Odd man rush here. All five Rams to counteract the three Rebels in the zone, and Morgan covers it up. .11:02 now left to go in this third period. Faceoff coming in the Rams zone. John Mueller take the faceoff for UNLV. Trying to come away with the puck. Looks like he's going to go down in the faceoff circle. Nelson comes away with it for the Rams. Sent around the boards. Coming back towards the blue line, and it's sent back down towards the corner again. And pass across. That one was a bullet, and now it's going the other way. Foundos on the right side with speed, but he's got a man on his back, and it looks like it's going to be an offsides play.
The Rams had numbers there. It was the beginning of a 3-on-2 play as it was just whistled offsides. Got a little bit too into the play, trying to jump ahead and speed it up.
Seen a couple of those happen for the Rams tonight, just a little bit eager on the line. Grayson North comes away with the puck, carries it in himself, has a stick coming in from behind, and now it's a race for the puck into the Rams zone. Miller gets there first for Colorado State. Now he's looking for options. Tries to use his teammate Nitchin to deflect it out of the zone, but right now the Rebels taking a shot. That's blocked on the way there, and now it's rushing going the other way. This is a high-speed play from the Rams. Onside play, shot coming. That one goes off the backboards and out of the zone. Now the Rebels trying to see if they can turn it into something for themselves. Puck comes out into the Rebels zone, and it's Riley going to get there first. He's going to send it around. Corey Taylor trying to give some support, but the Rebels able to get it on their stick. That's Williams. Helps send it into the zone. Jacob Morgan gets there first. Sent out towards center ice, but intercepted on the way there. A lot of those turnovers we were seeing last period, and that's one there. Rams able to get into the zone now. That's Gillis working his way around one or two. Puck bouncing around in the center, and it looks like we've got a penalty. Looks like this might be on the Rams for cross-checking. Now the Rams regain the lead in penalties. That is their fifth penalty of the night, first of this period. UNLV so far unsuccessful on the power play. Rams doing a good job on the penalty kill. Rebels come away with the faceoff win, and now working from the blue line, Williams hands it back across. Sent in deep towards the corner. Morgan hanging on to that right post. Working back towards the faceoff circle. Shot coming deflected, and now it comes towards the opposite side. Puck along the boards. Rebels trying to hang on to this offensive attack. Comes towards the blue line and out of the zone. Rebels have to restart. Just under 9 minutes left to go in the period. If you are just now joining us, we thank you for watching ColoradoSports.tv. You've missed some action here. It's tied at 2 right now, and The UNLV Rebels are on a power play against the Colorado State Rams. Intercepted, though. Rams looking to see if they can turn this into a shorthanded opportunity, possibly. Going to slow it down and just dump it in as the Rams go for a change. Now 1:10 left to go in the power play. Great job on the Rams' penalty kill so far this game. One more minute now. There's more time taken off the clock. We see the Rebels take a few extra seconds in their own zone to really prep their offensive strategies. Puck left for Cody Williams, who uses his speed a lot with the flowing hair in the wind on the side now. Puck near the blue line. And near the boards again, a little quick 1-2s from the player. Shot coming from the side. Glove save from Morgan, able to pick it out through the crowd. Well done from him. Now exactly 30 seconds left to go in the power play for the Rebels. Rams trying to hold on defensively here. They get ready for another faceoff. Cote applying some pressure is able to get the puck out of the zone, trying to take it away himself. He's able to create enough chaos that the puck comes out of the zone. Rebels carry it in. Looking to generate another offensive opportunity, carrying it around behind Morgan. Send it towards the blue line again. Fink sends it back towards the side. Carried in towards the center. Shot deflected. Kasaria laying down his body for that one. Rams able to get in the way again, trying to get it out of the zone. And it's knocked out of play, but they kill the fifth penalty of the game.
The Rams are doing a great job on the penalty kill tonight. Although generating a few more penalties than they would hope that they could, that they would, they have been strong on that penalty kill.
With 7:20 left to go, we're still tied at 2. The Rebels seem to be the ones applying the most pressure on offense right now, and the Rams are just trying to react defensively. Kyle Riley has it for Colorado State. Going to try and carry it out towards center ice and dump it into the zone, but it's blocked on the way there. Las Vegas trying to turn it the other way, but Founders has it on his stick for Colorado State, and he dumps it in. Rams are going to slow it down as Founders is just going to try and break up the play enough, but Rebels come away with the puck. Now it's at center ice, intercepted again. Rams doing a good job this period of getting in the way of the passes and being able to predict where it's going next. Rebels starting again from their own zone. We're seeing a little bit more of these deep passes and quick going backwards and a little shaking up of the plays from this Las Vegas side. Joseph has it on the stick for the Rams. Trying to dump it into the zone is Gillis. Now it's coming back the other way towards center ice. Leaves it for Gillis, and it's going to be carried in offside. Little mini series there before this face-off. Now we're at 6:10 left to go. Rosenthal, we see back out on the ice for the Rams. Paxton Malone, who just scored the last goal for UNLV, is now back out there as well. Sent out towards center ice again. Rebels looking to carry it in the zone, but pass is intercepted, but the Rams turn it back over. But again, they take it back. Nelson, able to get it back for his team, sends it across to Rosenthal, who's trying to hold on to possession, sends it around again. Nelson's going to get there first. Drops it back, right back where it came from. Rosenthal goes to get it again. Puck along the boards near the corner. Watch out for the shaking glass there as puck comes loose towards the center. Rebels come away with it. This might be a 3-on-2 opportunity. Malone on the right side, able to get it back towards the center. Shot coming, that one goes wide of the net. Another big opportunity. Shot wide, and now the Rams looking to turn it down the other way. 3-on-3, and it's poke-checked away. And a lot of quick speed plays. We're seeing it go the other way, but offside is called. .5:14 left to go in the period.
It's been a lot of back and forth action later in this period. as either team have had a few good chances.
Rebels working from their own zone now, specifically Hetzel, trying to work it out. Rams trying to hold on. Puck comes out to center ice, and now it's going into the Colorado State zone. Jacob Morgan takes a hit as he tried to leave it for Riley. It goes around. And Mayer trying to generate a play for his team. He's able to push it one more. Trading sticks between the teams. And now Fink has it on his stick. Sent across out of the zone now. UNLV has to reset. They come out of the zone and look to get this offense started again. Another hit along the boards. Rams are showing a lot of aggressiveness throughout this game. Puck tangled up in the corner again as we are just about to reach the four-minute mark of this period. Puck at the blue line, sent in. This might be a chance. Shot, deflected. Puck in the center. Rams trying to carry it out, and that's going to be CJ Nitschen going down. They're looking for a penalty, not going to get one. That is not sitting well with the fans, and we're going to see how the Rams respond to that. CJ Nitschen able to get around himself, but not get the puck around. Leaves it for North, sends it out of the zone, but the Rebels are going to carry it right back in. Moreno trying to poke check it away. Shot coming from the side, goes off the backboards. Sent in by Williams again. And try to get the pass along the blue line. Rams, Joseph able to block that and get it out of the zone. Puck at center ice, passed back in. Kasari is there for it for the Rams. Tries to backhand it out of the zone, but can't quite get enough force behind it. A couple players colliding behind Morgan's net, and now the puck is tangled up again. Comes loose towards the corner. Sent along towards the blue line. Williams is getting across, tries to get the centering pass. Loose puck in front, and it comes knocked towards the board. Looks like both sides getting riled up from this play right now. Rams trying to see if they can finally get something going on the other end. 2:50 left to go in the period. Pass towards the center. Moreno, Gillis now scrambling for it. Tries to leave it for Joseph. Joseph going to carry it himself, centering pass, but no Ram there for it. Rams are back on defense going the other way. Rebels trying to use their speed again on this right side. Corey Taylor trying to give a little bit of a check. Able to take the puck away. Joseph trying to use some of his speed to gain control. Cote now behind Morgan's net. Going to carry it himself. Working from his own zone. Rams going to go for a small change. Cote just trying to buy some time, and he goes down as he tries to press the attack by himself. Rebels setting up their five-man play now. Pass towards the center. See almost a little bit of a triangle working. It's pass from Edison's net towards the center, and then look left or right for him. Sent in towards the Rebel zone again. Legier is there for it. Catches it in the air. Leaves it for Taylor. Taylor on this left side. Shot coming, and Edison swallows that right up. 1:51 left to go in the period. We are still tied at two.
Finally seeing a good chance from the Rams here later in this third period, as they haven't had anything for a few minutes. That was a well set up play for a shot by Corey Taylor.
Rebels come away with the puck in their own zone after the faceoff. Sent across on the left side. That's Williams. Trying to find some options. He's got a man in the middle. Tries to get the pass across. Bouncing puck. Morgan tried to reach for it, but not able to get it around. Coming around the other side. Tried to get the shot. Goes off the side. Along the boards again. Williams getting contested by Campbell. Puck comes loose near the blue line. Sent across towards Hetzel. Hetzel has to carry it out of the zone. Towards center ice now. And Morgan comes out to play it on his stick. He tries to send it back around the boards. And we've got a whistle. Slowing down a little bit of play. And now we're at 1:06. Last time, we're starting to look at that overtime frame almost as we reach the end of this third period. Last time the Rams were in overtime was just last weekend when they faced off against the Buffaloes. And they came away with that win with 5.8 seconds left to go. And that was the only win that they've had in overtime. As far as UNLV, they are 0-2 in overtime, and they've never gone to a shootout. So both teams not too successful in the overtime frame. But now we've got less than 1 minute. The intensity continues to rise here at Epic Arena in Fort Collins, and it's deflected out of play. 48.5 seconds left to go now.
We got the Rams bench getting riled up, trying to help their team out, get another boost of energy.
Rebels trying to come away with the offensive faceoff win, and they do, trying to send it back in deep. And it comes around. It's going to go off of Morgan looking for another shot. Working off that left side. Just about 30 seconds now left to go in the period. Puck comes out of the zone. That's Engel, able to force it out. Rebels looking to restart. A lot of quick speed coming down. Shot towards Morgan. It's going to bounce off him. He's going to cover it up. Now 19 seconds left.
A bit of a scary moment there with less than 20 seconds left, that the puck went in and out of Joe Morgan's glove. Luckily, he was able to be aware of that and get down to cover that puck.
Yeah. Looks like we're going to have a timeout called with these 19 seconds left. And both teams are going to have to work out a strategy. The Rams have mostly been on these defensive play. And they're going to need to get something going the other way if they want to get the puck in the back of the other net. As far as what UNLV is doing, is there anything that you expect to see from them specifically, Tristan, as far as a strategy, or are you just kind of going into it blind?
Well, I'm definitely seeing the Rams' best players being played out there for the final few seconds. UNLV, though, they were switching it up, and their best players that are coming out now are the players that have a lot of energy to them still. So the Rams' side is a little bit more gas than UNLV, and we'll see the way this goes within those final 20 seconds.
See if that timeout helps either team in these final moments of the third period. Rams come away with the win, but not able to get it on their sticks after the opening pass. Rebels have it back now, just about 10 seconds left to go in the period, trying to get the shot off from the side. 7 seconds now, working from that right side along the boards. Taylor has it for his team. He's just going to try and hold it there and send it into overtime, and they do. So two games in a row now. We are going into overtime. And stay right in your seats, because we're not going anywhere. We're staying right here. Now, as far as these overtime matches go, again, last time Rams were successful. However, they have lost every other time that they've been in overtime. They are 1-4, which compared to the UNLV side, they are 0-2. So just a quick 2 minute break while the players figure out their plans and strategies for this overtime matchup. We've seen this a few times here in Fort Collins. And again, the Rebels are looking to take back the win that the Rams stole from them in their own turf. And it looks like the Rebels are already, we're almost ready. We already see Edison headed back out there, and it looks like the Rams are ready to match that. So as far as what we saw during that third period, a responding goal from that Rebel side tied it back up, and that brings us to where we are now, 2-2. No goals scored in the first, 3 scored in the second, 2 from the Rams on a power play, 1 on a 4-on-4 for the Rebels, and then an even strength goal in that third period. And after three periods, the Rams were back to what they looked like in the first, only getting four shots during last period to the Rebels 15. So the Rams being out pressured on offense, and now we have dropped the puck, and it's some 3-on-3 hockey. Rebels trying to get the early start here. For the Rams, we see Kasaria, Cote, and C.J. Nitschen out there on the ice. Rebels setting up their attack now, and we're seeing a lot of that speed. Gets around one, carrying it in, backhander towards Morgan. He stops one big save already early, and now it's trying to go the other way. 2-on-2 situation. Nitschen on that left side tries to get the shot, but it's blocked on the way there. Puck now behind Edison's net. Rebels looking to see if they can take this towards the Rams side now. Odd man rush, pass across, not able to get the stick on it for a good shot. Cote hands it off to Nitschen. Back to Cote again, a little 1-2 between them, and Cote's going to slow it down as Nitschen goes for his change, and Cote as well. Noah Miller comes out as well for his team, and Moreno loses his footing, but he's got time to deal with it. 1 minute now gone by in overtime. Moreno's going to carry it in himself, tries to get by one. He's in the zone, going to pass it to himself off the boards. He's now trying to set up a play here. He does not want to lose this puck here along the blue line. And he's going to carry it out of the zone, and he wants to reset the play. Hands it off to Legere. He's going to skate by Miller, hands it off to him on the way. And Miller slows it down as well. As far as the Rebel side, they're trying to just get possession of the puck back, which they had most of it. They had most of the possession time in that third period of action and probably the first as well. Rebels might have a chance here. 2-on-2 situation. Coming in towards this left side is Asaf, who scored the 4-on-4 goal in the second period. Passed across on the right side. Looking for options. Malone, who's going to turn it around. He also has. He has the other goal for his team tonight. Sends it around the boards. Playing from behind Morgan's net now. Going to try and carry it in himself. Little back and forth trickery he's going to use. Pass towards the side here, passed in deep, carried towards the blue line. Along the blue line now, Malone tries to send it in for the centering pass, and it's knocked wide of the net. 2:45 now left to go, pass near the blue line again, sent in deep towards the corner, carrying in from the right side, looking for the centering pass, not going to get it. Malone going to hang on to it himself as Corey Taylor applies some pressure, and he's going to take it away. And Taylor getting some pressure from Fink here. Does not want to lose the puck here. Bounces off the boards to Riley. Riley working from behind his own cage and almost has an own goal situation as he tried to pass it around and just got knocked towards Morgan. And Morgan, luckily, being attentive on the play, is able to react and keep that puck from going in.
If you're Kyle Riley, you just had the scariest moment ever. Your last home game here. Not for him, but for the season. Almost putting that puck in on your own goal.
Right now the Rebels keeping that pressure up, coming in on the side, not able to keep the puck control. Miller hands it off to Joseph, who's going to slow it down from behind his own cage. Hands it off to Cote. Cote probably going to look to see some of his speed right here. Carries it across the center line and into the zone. On the right side, shot coming, goes off the chest. Edison, you tried to get it out there before it was too late, but it was blown dead, and we now have 1:54 left to go in overtime. What a final game of the season if you've ever had one.
What a final last few games, as they've taken on their rival twice last weekend, both ending in overtime, one with a win.
One with a loss. See if they can come away with a victory tonight. Now 1:45 left to go in overtime. C.J. Nitschen getting tangled up in the corner there. Rebels come away with the puck. Moreno trying to apply some pressure. He's going to hand it off to Kazubski. Kazubski leaves it for Williams, carrying it himself, one-on-one situation. He's able to poke check it away. That's Kasaria, and he sends it out of the zone. Looks like he's just going to take the icing call, give his team a little bit of a chance to breathe. 1:17 now in overtime. As far as shootout situations go, if we reach that point, the Rams have been in a shootout here before. They've come away with the win there. UNLV has never been in a shootout this season. They have yet to get into that point, but as far as the shootout record for the Rams, they are 2-1, and it looks like we're going to have another timeout taken. So 1:17 left to go in overtime. We're seeing some big plays probably from both sides at this point. Tristan, is there anything you're seeing that's pretty significant in this overtime matchup as opposed to what we were seeing during the regular play?
Well, the goalies are standing tall, as we have seen this entire game. This face-off coming up, the players did just ice it, so they are not allowed to change. As Brian Caseria is trying to just make sure their team has that right, as they do want their new players out there.
So as far as who we have out on the ice for the Rams, it looks like we're going to see Tanner Gillis. Nope, he's sitting back out there, excuse me. So we're going to have C.J. Nitschen. Joe Morgan, obviously. Tito Moreno and Brian Caseria out there for the Rams. As far as that Vegas side, you see 23, DeAndre John. You got all the 20s out there. I believe we're going to see John, Asaf, and Meyer out there for the Rebels. Working from that right side, Rams are able to take it back. 1:10 left to go in the overtime matchup. Moreno tried to carry it out of the zone. Gets tangled up on the way there. Puck comes out to center ice, though. This might be a chance. Nitschen, he's got one man to beat. He's able to get the shot off, but it's a pad save. Caseria tries to send it back in deep. Nitschen has it behind the net. Tries to get the centering pass, but it's deflected. Sent back across. Rosenthal out there for the Rams, and he has it on his stick. He carried it out towards center ice, and the official got away, got in the way of the back pass, and it's now going the other way. Man goes down as Rosenthal reaches out his stick, tripping up the man on the possible one-on-one opportunity. And that seemed like it was just a little bit of bad circumstances. It bounced off the official skate, and that opened up the opportunity for the Rebels to take it down the other way. And that's a penalty on the Rams in these last moments of overtime. So the Rams, that's their sixth penalty of the night. 37.9 seconds left to go on the clock. That's how long the Rams have to survive with a man down.
And the coach on the UNLV side wanted a penalty shot on that. I'm not sure if I've ever seen a penalty shot here before, other than the eventual shootouts.
I can't say I recall one. Rebels come away with the face-off win. That's Williams. He's going to hand it off to Fink. Closing in. Shot coming. Bounces off Morgan. Scrambling for the puck. Now 26 seconds left to go on the clock. It comes out of the zone. Rebels have to reset. Official trying to stay out of the way on this one again. Askell Campbell trying to apply some pressure. Rebels restart. Just about 15 seconds in. Carrying it with speed on the left side near the blue line now. Fink again. Passing off the left side. Shot. Scrambling puck. Open net. Trying to clear it out of the zone. The Rams are in a panic mode. 5 seconds left. Rebels have to hurry if they want to put it in the back of the net. Pass across. Intercepted on the way there by Corey Taylor. And the final seconds tick down. Rams survive being one man down. And now we are headed into a shootout. Again, UNLV has never had to go to a shootout. The Rams have gone to it 3 times and been successful in 2 of them.
Well, this is how we started out here at Epic, but the first regular season games, like, that counted, as there was one scrimmage right before that.
And this is how we're going to finish.
This is how we're going to end it here today on this in this season. That was Sam Cote, number 8, the freshman for Colorado State, who ended that shootout for the win for Colorado State.
If I remember correctly, no one was scoring in that shootout, and he was the only one to score. He got the one and only goal during that shootout, which ended up being
the
win.
He was the 4th shot, I think. It's been a while, but...
Yeah. So we're going way back in time.
I still think I'd like to think that I remember it a little bit. At least I got the guy right.
So UNLV is going first. for the shootout, Paxton Malone to take the first shot against Joe Morgan in net for the Rams. Coming in through the center, a little bit on the other side, shot scores! The first one of the shootout is a goal for UNLV. Kyle Riley looking to respond. Eric Edison in net for UNLV. Riley slowly carrying it on the left side. A little bit of a deke, but he's going to shoot wide of the net, and now UNLV has the advantage.
Kyle Riley giving the UNLV bench a little few chirps on the way.
Now Bryce Woodward to take the second shot for UNLV. After the Rams were unsuccessful on their last one, looking to make it 2-0. Shot scored for number two. Now in favor of UNLV. Rams need to respond. Max Legere to take the next one for Colorado State. Carries it in on the right side. Coming in. Looking to get the backhander. Poke checked away. And that is going to do it. That's all they needed. Two shots and it's over. UNLV comes away with the win and they return the favor against Colorado State on their own turf. So after that, Colorado State has the final record of the season, 10-15-4-2. What a season we had for you. I'm sure that Tristan, we hope that you had as much fun as Tristan and I did during the season, and what a time it was. Rams go down against UNLV in their final match of the season. It was a fun one. We thank you for watching Colorado Sports TV with us. I'm Leetus Castro here with Tristan Anderson signing off for you this season. Have a great night, ladies and gentlemen.